I'm delighted to introduce the chairman of the Club Cricket Conference, Robbie Book. Good evening, Robbie.
Mr. President, how are you, sir?
I'm extremely well, thank you. And I hope you are as well. It's been quite a year for all cricket and particularly club cricket.
It certainly has. It's, you know, one of those things, Roger, that when we started the year with all hopes, and we've ended the year with more hopes. And in the middle, it's been a bit dismal.
Yeah, but many of the hundreds of clubs, of course, have benefited from your regular newsletters, which have covered a huge number of topics, and more newsletters than have ever gone out before.
Yes, I didn't intend to become a newsletter editor in my age, but it worked out that way. In fact, next week we'll be putting out the 31st of the year, which is not only a record for 1 year, it's a record for a decade, I think.
Yeah, that's absolutely brilliant. And also, you've been involved, I mean, you were quite involved with the ECB in getting club cricket back on again in August.
Well, as part of the National Cricket Conference, which is the body to which we are now part, we work very closely with the ECB in lots of areas and are able to help them along the road to find out what club cricket wants out of life. And that's really where the newsletter comes in again. And the result, I really appreciate the amount of feedback I get against that, so we can inform the ECB of what club cricket wants, because that's the only way they can know.
What would you, I mean, you know, you've had lots and lots of queries and things from clubs. What would you think is the most asked question of clubs this year?
Well, it's all based around uncertainty, but the bottom line of it is, volunteer fatigue is probably the thing that is most on the minds of many, many clubs now, because without our volunteers, we haven't got club cricket in this country, as we all know. And so we must keep everybody thinking about their club, involved with their clubs, even during this poor winter coming up ahead, and making sure they do understand that the club is still there. It's going to be there in May next year for them, and they need to be there with it.
And of course, the finances have been a big problem to clubs, haven't they, with no bar income and all that sort of thing?
Absolutely. We've been able to ensure that most clubs now understand what has been made available to them. So once again, through the newsletter, from grants and local stuff and what have you that the ECB have been pushing out, but also making themselves available within their communities to actually raise money locally for themselves as well.
However, on the bright side, when cricket did start, from what I've seen with the clubs I'm involved with, there was a huge uptake in the number of juniors and people and women and girls playing the game.
Absolutely massive. In fact, the one thing that we were short of towards the end of the season, from middle of July onwards, really, was grounds to play on. That was the biggest single problem. We had a huge numbers of juniors playing all the way through the summer. I'm hoping that will continue next year. I've been advocating it for a long time anyway. And it's very important that those juniors, not everyone does go on holiday in August and September.
No.
People go at different times. And it's much, much easier to keep cricket going and playing than stopping it and starting it again.
Yeah, well, if you live in Eastbourne like I do, you don't need to go on holiday anyway. I'm already here.
Yeah, but there aren't many juniors down your end, Roger.
Hey, steady. No, you're probably right, though. Now, I just want to touch on this area. It's not entirely this evening, but I just want you to mention the charity arm of the Club Cricket Conference, because it's done the most amazing job with supplying defibrillators to clubs.
Absolutely. We are the Club Cricket Charity, which is very close to my heart, is something which we set up about 7 years ago. And we've done a fantastic job working alongside the ECB to make sure that clubs with and without funding are able to have a defibrillator on the premises or in their kit bags, more importantly, so they can travel with it too, a portable defibrillator, which can save lives. And it has proved to be so in a number of occasions in the last 3 years.
No, that's absolutely. I just want to confirm to everybody right away, you're not sitting in the long room at Lord's. It's just a clever trick, isn't it?
Well, actually, yes.
And just finally, you know, the Club Cricket Conference has moved, and we've been around for over 100 years, and we provide teams and that sort of thing that play in centenary matches and against second 11s. And in the first days, you used to do thousands and thousands of fixtures, but now it's moved on to be a much more advisory body, which is a fantastic effort, really.
Well, thanks, Roger. And yes, it has been a great privilege to be able to get this going in the last 3-4 years. It's always been there. The Fixture Bureau is still there and working very hard with Stan and Ballot back in the office. We've got Donna with us this evening, who is without whom the Club Cricket Conference couldn't continue. And this is the first time she'll probably listen to everything, because she's normally counting money. But the Club Cricket Conference is an advisory body. We try to help everybody. The best way we can do it is by knowing what the clubs want, and then we can pass it on to the relevant authorities. That's what we're about now, including, of course, playing representative cricket, which we hope will not be decimated as it was this year, the next year.
And just finally, the money that we raise tonight is vitally important to make sure that this wonderful job that the Club Cricket Conference are doing is continued.
That's absolutely right. We have no other source of funds apart from the memberships which we have, which are diminishing, but we need the money in order to be able to continue the work that we do. And we believe it's terribly important from clubs' point of view that they do get the service which we do provide.
Thank you very much. Well, Robbie, you and your team and Donna and Stan, you do a wonderful job, and let's hope that everybody tonight gets behind you and that we have a damn good evening. So thank you very much indeed for chatting to us.